I'm Thomas Ross. I'm a staff scientist in the Neuroimaging Research Branch at the National Institute on Drug Abuse. So our branch uses brain imaging techniques to investigate issues in drug abuse. Principally, we use a technique called functional magnetic resonance imaging. We do it in a way that's sensitive to changes in blood flow. So you can imagine that if part of your brain is working harder, then it will need more oxygen. So there'll be a local increase in blood flow. And we can set up our MRI machine so that it's sensitive to those local changes in blood flow. It shows us what parts of the brain are needed to do certain things. Maybe if I asked you to make a risky decision, I might want to know what part of your brain changes during that risky decision, and maybe that differs between a drug user and a non-drug user. And we will create an image where the color of the image is related to how big the blood flow change is. As we take these images across time, these hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of images, and combine them to make a single image that represents changes related to whatever we're looking at. So when you see these images of colorful, we call them clusters or blobs, regions of activation overlaid on top of a brain, those colors represent how big the signal change was. So we hope to better inform the scientific community what parts of the brain are important and critical in drug abuse so that they could be targets for either some sort of behavioral therapy or some sort of pharmacotherapy to help end drug abuse.